Nano Machine by Anhong Weolja.
Chapter 384. Worth and Value. Part 1. 300 people? For a second, Yan Buso doubted his ears. There were 200 eunuchs from the Cardinal Spear right in front of them. They were people who surely had learned martial arts. They were at least third-class warriors. Is it even possible to suppress all of them at the same time? If one was a supreme master and a member of the 17 leaders of Yulin, they should be able to subdue the eunuchs without taking too long. However, it was a completely different matter to make them all kneel with just a single gesture. Even if we give it our all, we can only subdue 100 or so. Even making them kneel for long would be difficult. Normally one would use their energy to subdue others when they were fighting each other. It was a way to earn a bit of time for a defense. Impossible. No matter how much they thought about it, it was absolutely impossible to heed the Emperor's words. It could have been an exaggeration to say that 300 people had been forced to kneel all at once. They could both see the Emperor looking at them with anticipation. Ah, Your Majesty is testing me. Yan Biuso thought that he'd figured out the Emperor's true intention. It must have meant that he was indirectly asking Yan Biuso to showcase his ability to subdue the Lord of the Demonic Cult. What was even more interesting was that Yan Biuso still didn't think that Chen Youwen had reached the Divine Master level. His Majesty seems to be exaggerating about that gesture. Suddenly Pingyue's voice entered Yan Biuso's ear. He nodded in agreement. It seems like His Majesty wants us to show our capabilities. Pingyue could show his skills, but it was much better for Yan Biuso, who was stronger than him, to do so. In order to fulfill Great Leader Imak's order and to satisfy the Emperor, they had to show overwhelming force. However, the task they'd been given wasn't easy. That was when the Emperor opened his mouth. Can't do it. His subtle look of disappointment was clearly visible from afar. Yan Biuso was wrapping his head around the concept of victory. This man is quite clever. It was never my intention to showcase a power which could instill fear in the Emperor's mind. Is this an opportunity given by the Emperor? Yan Biuso strongly believed that he and Chen Youwen, the Lord of Demonic Cult, must have some fated relationship. In the future, if he became the great leader of Yulin and led his faction, he would be known as a warrior who had competed for the sake of Yulin in the Emperor's eyes. I cannot lose to him. Fuck. Yan Biuso placed his hands together and said. Of course we can, Your Majesty. However, I will show you something different, because my pride doesn't let me copy someone else's performance. Something different? Yan Biuso looked at the Emperor, who was puzzled. That was when swords hidden in the belts of the three eunuchs nearby got pulled out. Srrrng. Ugh. How did my sword? My sword. The three eunuchs couldn't hide their embarrassment when their swords got pulled out. No matter how skilled the man from Yulin was, they should have felt at least some kind of energy around them. Float. Ugh. The Emperor's eyes lit up. The three swords floating in the air moved as if they were alive. Among the eunuchs, the three people who'd lost their swords were shocked. Air sword. Air sword. It was a technique used to make a sword fly, something which only a supreme master could do. The other eunuchs mumbled and whispered amongst themselves. The Emperor looked over at Admiral Seo Taesik of the Cardinal Spear, who was standing on the other side. Seo Taesik, who understood what he meant, sent a telepathic message to the Emperor. Your Majesty, that technique is considered to be one that could rival a member of the five strongest warriors in Wulin. In Wulin, the only people who were officially known to have achieved the Supreme Master level were the five strongest warriors. Of course, even in Yulin, several people preferred to hide their skills. It was shocking that a man in his 30s could use this skill. Five strongest warriors? Even the Emperor was aware of the five strongest warriors in Wulin. The guardian escort, who had died while protecting him, was also someone who had shared that title 90 years before. Even in the Yulin faction, he'd heard that only the great leader of Yulin could do it, but to see the eldest son perform it in the throne room was a surprise. Is the Lord of the Demonic Cult one of the five strongest warriors? The Emperor asked in a low voice. Seo Taesik shook his head and sent another telepathic message. No. As far as I know, the former Lord of the Demonic Cult was one of them, but not the current one. Really? The five strongest warriors are said to be warriors who are the best in what they do. Then how could Lim Gyua, someone who formerly held that same title, get killed in a couple strikes? Just remembering that made a shiver run down the Emperor's spine. However, what was even more shocking was that the people of Yulin didn't seem to be aware of Chun Yuan's power or his capabilities. Those with great talent get known to the world even when they try to hide it. That could be how the Lord of the Demonic Cult becomes known. Being an emperor, he couldn't quite understand how the rankings within Wulin worked, but he was sure of it. That one day, the name Chun Yuan, a wise man, would hold the title of being the best in the world. Maybe that was why he wasn't so impressed with Yan Biuso's power. Who will become the best amongst the strongest warriors? Even if the leaders of the forces of justice or the leaders of other factions came over directly to showcase their power, the emperor thought that they wouldn't amount to anything before Chun Yuan. Yan Biuso, who didn't know what the emperor was thinking, was wondering what kind of things he had to show next to move the emperor's heart, and then decided it was to show the strongest technique one could use. Yan Biuso walked 3 steps ahead and drew a circle around him with his toe. The eunuchs were puzzled. Suddenly, Yan Biuso spoke to the emperor. "Majesty, then I will subdue the people in this room without taking a single step from this circle." That much even the Lord of Yan Biuso waved his hand before the emperor could finish his words, and the 3 swords which were in the air moved around the room. Yan Biuso spoke to the eunuchs. "If you manage to push me out of the circle, I will admit defeat." It was arrogance. At that very moment, Yan Biuso moved his hand, and the 3 swords which were in the air accelerated and quickly passed between the eunuchs, drawing up numerous trajectories. Swoosh! The sound of something passing by rang in the eunuchs' ears. The swords which were moving around could stab them at any moment if they took another step. "Stop it!" Clang! 200 eunuchs drew their swords to stop the air sword. In order to not get in the way, Pingyu decided to create some distance. "It is an air sword, so this will definitely work out in our favor." Originally, Yan Biuso had intended to use it right away, however, it took some time for him to collect the energy needed. However, it wasn't too long. "Push him out of the circle." Wah! The eunuchs of the Cardinal Spear rushed towards Yan Biuso at once. He had declared that he could accept defeat if he got pushed 1 step out of the circle. "Push him forcefully." No matter how well known he was in Yulin, there were 200 people in the throne room. What could he possibly do to stop them? That was what the eunuchs were thinking, but would a strategy made by a supreme master be that easy to breach? "Brilliant Sky Sword." Yan Biuso muttered something and raised his hand to the sky. At that moment, the 3 swords across the room began flying between the eunuchs. Swoosh! Sharp sounds were created by the air sword passing through the gaps between the eunuchs, leaving behind a gust of wind. "Wuhian! Ugh! This wind!" It was almost like a blast of wind. And the place where Yan Biuso was standing looked like the eye of a typhoon. The eunuchs who came to attack him bounced away and fell back. Thud! Oh! The emperor who was watching this seemed slightly impressed. If the Lord of the Demonic Cult displayed a demonic spirit, Yan Biuso's was more like a warrior's skill. Ugh! Clothes! What was even more shocking was that the uniforms of the eunuchs were being violently torn apart, which meant that Yan Biuso handled his sword so sophisticatedly that he made sure no eunuch was harmed. Pingyu clicked his tongue. "I was thinking he would show something nice, but he just keeps proving that he is a monster." He hadn't expected Yan Biuso to possess such a high-level technique. Even he, who had been active in Yulin for 20 years, was speechless. Even the emperor himself would have no choice but to admit it. "We have absolutely succeeded." Yan Biuso smiled slightly. The technique he was using had been made with the help of his father, Imak. Imak was the kind of person who preferred different ideas. He'd made a new technique that could control the air freely, and what Yan Biuso was displaying was his father's skill. "How was it? Your ma?" Yan Biuso's expression hardened as he looked at the emperor's expression. He'd thought that he had succeeded, but the emperor looked strangely more disappointed than surprised. "It is amazing, but is that all?" "Sorry." The emperor wasn't satisfied with what he'd seen. In fact, there was no particular surprise because what he just seen could be done by Lim Gyua. What went wrong? Pingyu, who was sure that they would win the emperor's heart, was perplexed. He couldn't understand at all what Chun Yuan had done to make the emperor's heart not move even once to his marvelous show of supreme strength. "Nothing more." Your Majesty? The Emperor's tone sounded like he'd lost interest in them, which made Pingyu unsure of how he was supposed to deal with the situation. Your Majesty? The skills which the leader has just shown you are something that even the five strongest warriors in Wulin. Before he could finish, the Emperor's eyebrows rose. Do you think that I don't know the five strongest warriors? I didn't mean it. He isn't present now, but my personal guardian escort was one of those five. Strongest warriors too. Even you people must know about it. Was it Wave Sword? There was no way they wouldn't know. 90 years ago, he'd been called the Sword Emperor, someone whom no one else could match. Yurian Buso? Yes, Your Majesty. I know that you are good. Then, would you be able to defeat the Guardian with three strikes? Sorry. Yun Byuso's eyes fluttered. No matter how much his skills improved, he was still a supreme master. Could he defeat someone of such great power in three strikes? When Yun Byuso hesitated without saying anything, the Emperor waved his hand. My decision hasn't changed. You can leave. Your Majesty? They knew that it would be difficult to convince him, but they didn't expect that it would be this hard. They simply didn't know it. But Yun Byuso's skill was what had made the Emperor grow even firmer in his decision. This is a problem. If this goes on, the Sky Demon Order will be fully instated as the state religion. The greatest disgrace to the forces of justice. Pingyue, who didn't want to give up, fell to the ground and pleaded with the Emperor. Your Majesty, I know that you are very disappointed with the last incident, but we forces of justice can do as much. Your Majesty? Your Majesty? Before Pingyue could even finish speaking, a shout was heard from outside the room. It was close to howling, but it could be heard inside the throne room. The Emperor frowned and looked at Admiral Seo Taesik. What is all the fuss? I will find out. When Seo Taesik looked over, he saw a couple of eunuchs rushing out of the throne room. Not long after, they came running back in, one after another. Their faces, blue, and their clothes were soaked in sweat from running. Thud! Your Majesty, we have critical information. How many times have I told you people not to make a fuss inside the palace grounds? What happened this time? Judging from the Emperor's tone, it seemed that this was something that happened quite often. Since the announcement about the abolition of Taoism, the number of teachers who came in to complain had been troublesome. Your Majesty, please let us continue the talks. Wasn't the very Empire the one who let Taoism flourish from the days of the first Emperor? How could we allow those evil demonic cult to enter and dismantle our temples? Pingyue's face hardened at the words of one of the people who'd come in. He thought that something must have happened to delay Monk Sathi's entry into the throne room, but it seemed like something had definitely happened. That was when Yun Byuso grabbed the teacher who'd come in and asked, "Hold on. Did the Lord of the Demonic Cult appear in the temple too?" "Ugh, how did you know?" Yun Byuso's eyes widened at the teacher who questioned him back. He'd asked out of curiosity to know if the Demonic Cult's Lord had appeared in the Imperial Palace or not. Wait, the Lord of the Demonic Cult came here? Then wouldn't we have a better solution? Whilst contemplating, Yun Byuso came up with an idea to persuade the Emperor. The Emperor seems smitten by the Lord of the Demonic Cult. If I can't persuade them, then it might be better to prove myself to be superior to him. This was an opportunity he couldn't miss. Yun Byuso explained his plan to Pingyue, who was still kneeling on the ground. Hearing that, Pingyue was hesitant for a while and then agreed. It seemed like a waste of time to stand in the throne room trying to convince the Emperor, so they decided to opt for another way. They decided to make the Emperor know that they had given up. Your Majesty, we are taking a step back. The Emperor clicked his tongue as he looked at the two people who had every intention to return here. What they wanted to do was clear to everyone present. Everyone noticed how Yun Byuso's eyes twinkled when he heard that the Lord of the Demonic Cult was in the Imperial Palace. They are stupid. These are the kind of people who have to taste defeat in order to know that they are nothing but insects. They wanted to stop them, but what could be done? The eunuchs were able to understand the saying, "Too much curiosity shortens one's lifespan." Ta-da-da-da-ta-da! Some people were rushing to the southeast of the Imperial Palace. The one at the forefront was a eunuch of the Cardinal Spear, followed by Pingyue, Yang Byuso, and the Ping family warriors. He will surely deal with you too. Huh? When they were leaving the throne room, the emperor said something incomprehensible. They didn't know what he meant, but this was the only chance they had. If we subdue the lord of the demonic cult, we can change the emperor's heart. The emperor wasn't showing any signs of it, but he was afraid of the lord of the demonic cult. Even after seeing Yun Biuso's skills, he'd stuck with the demonic cult. Sir, have you seen the lord of demonic cult before? At Pingyu's cautious question, the eunuch who was leading them nodded his head. I guess you can say that. To be honest, I don't think that this eunuch will be able to feel what I felt that day from the lord of demonic cult from anyone else. Even though he said that, the eunuch shuddered at the memory of what had happened. Because of the emperor's interest, the eunuchs had seen various factions of Yulin, and the eunuchs would compete with them too, but the man they'd met in the underground shrine made those other people seem worthless. He is not a person. He should be called a monster or a demon god. Demon god? Yun Biuso frowned. This eunuch was speaking in the same way that Elder Changsu had. It made him wonder how strong the lord of the demonic cult really was. I am getting excited. The fact that I finally get to meet the man who can stand against me. His right hand, which held his most beloved sword, trembled. He couldn't help but be disappointed when he was informed that the lord of demonic cult had left, but when he heard that he was back, Yun Biuso couldn't hold back his excitement. That place. The eunuch pointed to a building that looked like a temple. They'd thought that the battle would be in full swing since Monk Sathy hadn't returned, but the place was quiet. Ah? But through the gap in the temple gates, they could see nuns kneeling. They were none other than the female disciples of the Hangsen clan. How could that happen? Pingyu's face grew distorted. Those women had gone over to stop the dismantling of the temples, however, they appeared to be the ones who had been subdued instead. What exactly happened to Monk Sathy? Nah. Anger rose in Pingyu's heart, but he quickly calmed himself. He'd thought that all his efforts would end up making Yun Biuso the star of the show, but it seemed like he had a chance to prove himself. I will lead the members of the demonic cult to Yun Biuso and aim for the Lord. All he wanted to do was to build enough prestige as a member of the forces of justice, and then he'd get the arm of a true gentleman. Clang! Thinking up to this point, Pingyu pulled out his thunderbolt blade, a family heirloom. Warriors of Ping, draw your swords. The time has come to save the brothers and sisters. Wah! Clang! 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 25 elite warriors of the Ping family had their morale raised at the words of the clan head. In the Ping family, Pingyu was the only one who had achieved the superior master level. The one who followed was a lieutenant, a supermaster. He prided himself on being strong enough to never get pushed back by the enemy. Leader Yun, I will be the first one to strike. You can do what you want. Yun Biuso happily nodded at Pingyu's words as he showed great determination. Wung. He was determined to do his best from the beginning after having failed to restore the emperor's trust. Follow me. Fight. Bang. Pingyu passed through the temple gate in an instant. Yun Biuso tried to follow in, but something suddenly gave him chills. What was that? Energy? It was then. A sudden ear-piercing scream erupted from inside the temple. Quack! Shocked, Yun Biuso and the warriors of the Ping clan passed through the gate and entered the temple, only to see Pingyu, who had entered the temple with unbounded enthusiasm, kneeling in front of someone. No? However, something was weird. As he knelt before the man, Biuso realized that his right arm was nowhere to be found and that blood was gushing from the fresh cut. El leader? The warriors of Ping clan shouted. Yun Biuso hurriedly stopped them from moving further into the temple in anger. Stop! At the same time, Yun Biuso looked at the person standing in front of Pingyu. A young man with long hair and fair white skin stood there, and to his surprise, Pingyu's missing right arm was being held in his hands. The young man brushed his long black hair and spoke. Hohu, there is so much arguing, there seems to be a lot of people getting their arms cut off today. Chapter 385. Worth and Value. Part 2. Ping House. They were considered to be among the three famous households of the Jianghu. Along with his half-brother, they turned into one of the top five strongest groups in Jianghu. Although he was a member of the forces of justice, he had ambitions unlike his docile father. He didn't have as much talent in martial arts as his younger brother had, but he wanted to be in a third leader's position, where he gets called the backbone of martial arts. And to get to that position, it took a lot of work. Blade God 6 Martial Clan is too risky. They lacked the information and the Blade God 6 Martial Clan was too strong for the Ping House to face off against. Meanwhile, an opportunity arose. The absurd thing of the Empire's religion being changed. There were two reasons for it. The new lord of the demonic cult, Chun Yuan, who entered the Imperial Palace, and Elder Chongsu, who went to the palace as an envoy to renew the non-aggression treaty. Elder Chongsu is the 12th leader. Since he stepped down, the existing leaders will get promoted one by one. But that won't be enough. And as he aimed for the third leader, he would have to climb more and faster. He never thought of an opportunity to come. If he could rectify what Elder Chongsu had done, he could get a high position. But there was one thing he overlooked. Before stepping down, Elder Chongsu had mentioned several times that the lord of the demonic cult was a monster. Yet, not a single person believed him. This makes no sense. He reached the Divine Master level? Fut! He should at least make excuses along the lines of not feeling well that day. Pingyu didn't pay much attention to the elder's words. It was impossible to believe that a person who was in the Superior Master level a few months back went beyond numerous stages and reached Divine Master level. But there is nothing wrong with being careful, just in case. Both Elder Chongsu and the eunuch, even the Emperor, seemed afraid of the Lord of Demonic Cult. Perhaps the Lord was skilled and versatile enough, or in the worst case scenario, the end of Superior level. If that was the case, it would be difficult for Pingyu, who would be lower than Chun Yuan, to take him down. Bang! Pingyu entered the gate of the temple at once by using energy and quickly looked for an opponent he could face. On the stairs, in front of the temple, stood a tall, muscular man and a young man in a blue hood. The moment he saw them, Pingyu recognized them as superior masters. That guy must be the Lord. The man with the big beard looked almost the same age as him. But the man with the blue hood seemed like a young man. In addition, a foreign energy was subtly oozing out of him. Then my opponent has to be that muscular man. He could deal with the hooded man immediately, but before he went for the Lord, he needed to spill blood of the demonic cult to boost his men's morale. Even people of the demonic cult had emotions. Even their morale would drop if they saw one of their own die. That guy. In the meantime, Pingyu saw a young man standing in the courtyard. Unlike the other members of the demonic cult, he was wearing a luxurious black robe and his energy seemed very ordinary. It could be a teacher or a regular middle-ranked member. Pingyu was looking for a victim. Though he seemed weak, this man could also be an important figure as he looked like a teacher, so he rushed to the man. Huh. How dare you aim for our brothers and sisters? You cultists? He tried to cut down the young man's head with one swing. The moment he beheads this young man, Yan Biuso and other warriors of the family will enter the temple immediately. Ugh. That was when Pingyu's plan went awry. Slash. The young man's head definitely should have been cut off, but it moved away with an afterimage. Pingyu's eyes widened. Ho-ho? He too was able to move at a fast speed, but never had he seen someone move at a speed where afterimages were left behind. Where? Fight! As he tried to find him, someone grabbed his right wrist. The young man disappeared and moved to his right. Damn it! The moment Pingyu was about to move and wield his blade, he felt something creepy. If you avoid it, I need to avoid it. Tuck! Pingyu, who caught onto an ominous feeling, wielded his sword with all his might and tried to widen the distance. However, he was caught and his body wasn't moving. Ugh! WH, what kind of power? There was one surprise after another. The young man's hand was aiming to hit Pingyu's right shoulder. Pingyu could see a blue light shine in the young man's hand. Don't! Slash! Ah! A scream erupted from Pingyu's mouth as the sharp energy cut through his flesh and bones. It was his first time feeling such pain. It hurt so much that it felt like tears would flow out of his body, but the young man who was holding his severed hand and spoke with a cold voice. Kneel. Kook. Bang. Apart from the loss of balance in his body due to his arm, some invisible force pushed down on him. It was clear to Pingyu that he wouldn't be able to stand at all. It felt like his entire body was incapacitated. Quack! TH, this makes no sense, he is a monster. How can he do this in the palace? No. It can't be. Pingyu blinked his eyes. The words of Elder Changsu flowed back into his mind when he was down on his knees. He is a monster, no, he is the demon god himself. Pingyu raised his head with trembling eyes and looked at the young man in front of him. The white face and strong eyes. The feeling of intimidation was no joke, but no matter how much he looked, it made no sense. A superior master getting overpowered by something with normal internal energy. Th, this means he is a divine master. Is that really true? Pingyu could feel how foolish he had acted. Out of all the people present in the temple, why did he have to choose the lord of the demonic cult? Wh, what have I done? Pingyu was at a loss for words. Just then, Yan Biuso, the eldest son of the great leader of forces of justice, and the other warriors of the Ping House entered the temple. Chun Yuan ruffled his long hair to the back and spoke. Hohu, there is so much arguing, there seem to be a lot of people getting their arms cut off today. Yan Biuso's trembling eyes looked at Chun Yuan. He never imagined that Pingyu, a member of the forces of justice, would get taken down so fast.
No.
Looking to the right, he saw the monks of the Hangzhen clan kneeling, and in front of them was Monk Sathi. Monk Sathi. He was shocked at what he saw. The great warrior and swordsman Monk Sathi, being on her knees, shocked them. Her blood points were hit and she couldn't move her blood-drenched body, but she tried to say something to them. Don't try to touch that man. She was unable to move her tongue and mouth. If they didn't want to turn into her, she wanted to warn them to run away, but she was stuck. All of a sudden, members of the demonic cult blocked the entrance, and at the center was a person wearing a unique mask. The Dark King. The notorious nickname. He was known as a master who was among the top three of the demonic cult. Their actions said that people were supposed to come in, but weren't allowed to go out. Leader Yan. Monk Sathi looked at Yan Biuso, the eldest son of the forces of justice, with worried eyes. Her only hope was him, but things didn't look good. Is he trying to fight the lord of the demonic cult? Unlike the other warriors of Ping, Yan Biuso's warriors were only staring at Chun Yuan. It clearly said that he was planning something. It is him. No doubt. Yan Biuso confirmed who the lord of demonic cult was in a single glance. There was only one person whom he couldn't recognize as a beginner of the supreme master level. Regardless of the age, the young man held dignity that gave off the vibe of someone who's the one and only winner that gets to choose everything. He couldn't explain it, but he just knew who the lord of demonic cult was. Tremble. Yan Biuso's body trembled. When he saw the lord, Chun Yuan, who he thought of as someone like a rival, a shiver ran through his body. He would have been disappointed if he was less than expected, but this feeling was too great. He has strength that even I can't fathom. He truly is my soulmate. Fate finally bound him to his mate. To meet such a great match outside the Yulin. He was deeply moved. It was a happy thing to have a strong opponent who made one feel nervous enough to risk their life for. Clench. Strength entered his hand which was holding the sword. He wanted to draw the sword completely, but Yan Biuso wasn't stupid. Yan Biuso put his hands together and shouted. It is an honor to meet the lord of the demonic cult. I am Yan Biuso, the eldest son of the forces of Justice Great Leader and the leader of North Justice Blade. North Justice Blade. There were four armed groups in the forces of justice, which had immense power. One of them was North Justice Blade, a group made up of only the best of the best warriors within the forces of justice. They were an elite group of distinguished warriors who even killed numerous cultists when war broke out in the past. Yan Biuso. Ko Wonger was shocked when he heard the name. Even though it was shocking that he was the son of the North Justice Blade's leader, Yan Biuso was called a part of the next generation's five strongest warriors not just in Jianghu but in the entirety of Wulin. The Yulin must be shaken up quite a bit to send this man here. The state religion, which hadn't changed for 200 years, was taken away without a warning. Chun Yuan, who thought that the forces of justice would react, returned right after he was done with his work in the 10,000 mountains and it seemed like the right decision. The son of Yulin's North Justice Blade. During his days as a student, Chun Yuan was compared a lot to this guy by the elders. He heard that there was a genius or monster in Jianghu. But it doesn't matter. Fuck. Chun Yuan threw the severed arm of Pingyu to the floor and stepped forward. He only took a couple steps forward, but the warriors of Ping stepped back unconsciously. What energy! It wasn't because they came to know that he is the lord of demonic cult, but from the moment they entered the temple, something just didn't feel right. In a calmer voice, Chun Yuan spoke to Yan Biuso. This is good. Then you must be the representative of the forces of justice. That for now, I think it's okay to call me that. Yan Biuso glanced at the leaders. Including the two leaders, he was nowhere near their ranks. Both were seriously wounded and in enemy hands. We were prepared for the attack. Ah? At the cold voice of Chun Yuan, Pingyu came back to his senses. They were the ones who tried to subdue the lord of demonic cult to persuade the emperor and acknowledge the Yulin arts. But it was decided as such, thinking that Chun Yuan was weaker than Yan Biuso. Yan. Leader Yan can't face him. Even if he was being considered as one of the five strongest of the next generation's warriors and was being called a monster, the two of them were on completely different levels. The lord of the demonic cult was someone where even all of the five strongest warriors together will have a hard time taking him down. Leader Yan, don't. It is better for us to give up on this matter of religion. It was Pingyu who sent the message to Yan Biuso. He tried to deter Yan Biuso from fighting the lord of demonic cult. Looking at him, Yan Biuso shook his head. Lord Yan, it is foolish to fight. Before Pingyu finished, Yan Biuso took a step towards Chun Yuan. Fuck! He bowed his head and spoke. Lord, first of all, I would like to apologize for attacking your temple. Pingyu was shocked at what Yan Biuso said. Contrary to what he was worried about, Yan Biuso unexpectedly bowed his head and apologized. Even Chun Yuan was taken aback with the unexpected action. Stepping back, it was completely different from the constant glare he was giving from the moment he stepped into the temple. Yan Biuso spoke very softly. From our point of view, the temples in the empire had been established from the beginning of the founding and suddenly, it was changed. We were only here to meet with the emperor and ask him to reconsider. We didn't want to choose this method by any means. Yan Biuso seemed to be speaking the truth, a man of political influence. There was no reason why he would try to deceive the lord of the demonic cult, as everything he spoke about was something the demonic cult knew. When Chun Yuan, who was exuding vicious energy, quietly focused on his words, Yan Biuso brought in the main topic. In that sense, I think that this has happened because of some contribution from your cult too. Contribution? Chun Yuan's eyes rose. Not caring, Yan Biuso continued. Didn't the forces of justice and your cult form an alliance to take down a common enemy? I don't think that the lord of the demonic cult would want the alliance to break down because of this. Ah? At the words of Yan Biuso, Monk Sathi and Pingyu sighed in relief. They thought that he bowed his head to overcome the situation, but Yan Biuso seemed to have used his mind. He proved that he wasn't just skilled in martial arts. I will take a step back for the sake of the alliance. So, with a little courtesy, I hope the two leaders and their disciples will be released. A good move, leader. Monk Sathi praised the man in her mind. After all, the emperor would only change his heart when the lord of the demonic cult gets subjugated. However, it was impossible to do it in the palace, where all his forces were gathered, so it was better to focus on preserving their already existing power. He said that he would give up on the state religion, so it is an offer that the lord of the demonic cult can't refuse. In order to face the common enemy, Blade God Six Martial Clan, the lord of the demonic cult will try to avoid breaking the alliance. I beseech you. Yan Biuso politely bowed again. The son of the great leader, who is supposed to lead the clan and the forces of justice in the future, came this far for a reason. He was taught in the most eloquent way possible, even though he knew that the lord of demonic cult had no other option. At least, that was what he thought. You are misunderstanding something. They thought that he had no choice but to accept it, but Chun Yuan's reaction was different. Chun Yuan walked slowly towards Yan Biuso, one step at a time. The state religion lies in the emperor's hand, whether you concede or not doesn't matter to anyone. Since that matter can't be overturned, aren't you just trying to do anything you can? Yan Biuso was speechless at what Chun Yuan said. And it is disappointing to think that you don't want the alliance to be broken by doing nothing and playing word games with me. Srrrng. Chun Yuan, who approached Yan Biuso, was 10 steps away from him when he drew the white dragon blade. Lord of demonic cult. I mean it, the alliance will Brea? Stop speaking nonsense. I'll take your arm or you do so in return. Arm? Wong. A horrifying energy released all around. Each cell in Yun Byuso was telling him to face the person he wanted to meet. There is nothing I can do. He failed to make sure that the leaders were released without any harm done to them. It seemed that the lord of the demonic cult wasn't an easy one to face. In the end, it seemed like he ended up in a situation that he wanted from the very beginning. The two leaders looked at Yun Byuso in an apologetic manner. The leaders must be feeling bad. The lord is stronger than me, so I tried to avoid any more bloodshed, but it seems like he and I are destined to compete. Judging from it, their fate was tied too strongly for anything to come between that. Sighing, Yun Byuso slowly pulled out his blade from his waist. Srrng. Aiming his sword at Chen Youwan, who was walking close to him, he spoke. I think you two must be aware. I mean, this kind of existence is called family rivalry. When you were in school, you must have been called a genius too, just like ID. Clang. Before he could finish his words, cold energy passed through his right arm. Because of the speed at which things happened, Yun Byuso wasn't able to even know what happened. Drip. Thud. His right arm, which was holding onto the blade, fell to the stone floor. Quack. Chen Youwan's low voice entered his ears as he screamed in pain. What am I supposed to do if you are a genius? Cook. But the cut was too painful, but Yun Byuso widened the distance between them. Naturally, he did expect to get pushed back because of the difference in their powers, but he never thought that he would lose his arm. I couldn't even see him. What an unbelievable amount of energy. It was obviously cut from the front, which meant Yun Byuso reacted too late. What would one call it? When one gets hurt, knowing that it would happen. Chen Youwan stepped on the fallen right hand and asked. I got paid. Do you still want to continue? Even Yun Byuso, who was always calm and never showed any significant emotional changes, spoke in anger. How dare you insult me? Tat attack. With the help of his blood points, he managed to stop the blood flow. I should avoid fighting up close. He managed to create some distance between the two. Biting down on his lips, he gently moved his left hand. Clang. 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 Apart from the blade which fell on the floor, two blades were tied to his back, but he controlled all three swords at the same time. It was the same technique that he had shown in front of the emperor. Ha ha ha. I was careless before, but this time, it will be different. As Yun Byuso waved his left hand, the three blades quickly moved in the midair, blurring the vision and rushed towards Chen Youwan. Swoosh! 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 He was proud when showing the technique that he had learned from his father Imak. Even if he was the lord of demonic cult, Yun Byuso thought that it would prove difficult to prevent getting hit by it. However, something unexpected happened. Swoosh! Chen Youwan extended his hands to the side where the three blades were flying towards him. The air sword stopped right in front of Chen Youwan. H-Hal? Flustered, Yun Byuso tried to raise the sword force even more, but the three blades had already stopped. They literally didn't move. Even his father couldn't stop air swords. Wait a moment, lord of demonic cult, this is, you should have quit it when your arm was cut off. Wing. When Chen Youwan slightly moved his hand, the three blades turned back and it felt like they were aiming for the owner of the blades. Papet. Quack. The blade struck both his thighs and the opposite shoulder and they roared. Blood gushed out of his mouth. Cough. Yun Byuso was dumbfounded looking at his blade stuck to his body. Such strength was unfair. Kook, isn't he too strong? Is he really at divine master level? Yun Byuso had just assumed that Chen Youwan must have been at the end of supreme master level. He never thought that he would see someone who reached divine master level in his life. He never even heard of any divine master level existing among them. He is a real monster. Only after being hit was Yun Byuso able to face the reality like the other leaders. This person is different from me. He was never Yun Byuso's rival. Chen Youwan approached Yun Byuso, who was vomiting blood on the floor. It seemed like his end was near. This was a natural procedure in battles. Quack, what do you plan on doing? Kill me? But this will make the forces of justice your enemy. What bullshit are you spouting? Why would I kill you? What do you mean? Chun Yeowon looked down at him with a cynical look and spoke. You are a good hostage that I can use at any point in time. This he is really. Chun Yeowon always left the other person speechless.